in the previous lecture, we are discussing about the molecular representations. So, five different types of molecular representations are there. Already, this representation is over. Next, second type of molecular representation is Fischer representation. So, how the three-dimensional molecule is represented in a two-dimensional plane? So, with the help of Fischer projection, now we will see. So, these are the important points regarding the Fischer representation. So what is the first point means? The molecule is representing in the horizontal and vertical lines. See, the molecule is representing with the horizontal and vertical lines. So intersection point of these lines may be carbon atom or heteroatom. Heteroatom means here oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, phosphorus, anything. That means other than carbon atom, we can consider as the remaining all atoms are hetero atoms. Carbon and hydrogen atom, remaining all atoms are hetero atoms. See, the vertical line and horizontal line. This intersection point, it may be carbon or hetero atom. Hetero atom is here, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur or phosphorus. Next.
The groups on vertical line away from the observer. What is the meaning of this one? The groups on vertical line.
That means, suppose if I will take A and B. These two groups present on vertical line. These two groups are away from the observer. Next.
The groups which are present on horizontal line.
This is the horizontal line.
So the groups which are present on horizontal line towards the observer.
If I will say, if I will take C and D, it is these two groups are towards observer. Simply I will represent like this.
Already in the Wedge representation I told you away from the observer is represented with dotted bonds or broken bonds, broken wedge.
In this special projection the horizontal lines are towards the observer represented with the thick bond. The groups which are present on vertical lines away from the observer represented with the dotted. Therefore, I will represent it like this. With respect to this intersection point, these two groups are away from the observer. Therefore, I will write A. These two groups are towards the observer with the dotted bonds, I will like this. That means these two bonds come out of the board towards my side. C and D towards my side and A and B back side of the board. Away from my side or back side of the board. So C and D is existing my side like this and A and B existing like this. Okay. So this is the meaning of point number 3. The groups are vertical line away from the observer and the groups on horizontal line towards the observer. Right? Next, fourth point. Keep long carbon chain on vertical line by placing more oxidizable group on top of the vertical line. What is the meaning of this one? That means the long carbon chain. Suppose if I will take propane, CH3, CH2, CH3. This is the propane molecule. So 1, 2, 3. 3 carbon atoms are there. How I will represent this? Propane molecule into Fischer projection means I will write 3 carbon atoms like this. I will write 3 carbon atoms on the vertical carbon. Therefore, this is about first carbon, 3 hydrogen. Hydrogen. Next, the second carbon atom is this one. This is first carbon, second carbon. Second carbon contains 2 hydrogens, hydrogen. Next, the third carbon contains 3 hydrogens, hydrogen, and hydrogen, like this. That means the longest carbon chain will come under vertical line. This is the meaning of this one. Okay, always place longest carbon chain taken as a vertical line. On vertical line, you should take long chain carbon. Long chain carbon you will take as a horizontal, sorry, vertical line. Remaining groups you will place in horizontal positions. Hydrogens you will place in horizontal position. That is the meaning of the group. Next, another point is there here. Highly oxidizable group on top of the vertical. Highly oxidizable group and the group which contains less number of hydrogens or more number of oxygens. Oxidizable group and highly oxidizable group and ఐడి ఆక్సిజన్ గ్రూప్ లో పెట్టండి మోర్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఆక్సిజన్ ఆటమ్స్ మోర్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఆక్సిజన్ ఆటమ్స్ ఉండాలి అండ్ ఇట్ హస్ లెస్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ హైడ్రోజన్స్ ఇట్ షుడ్ బి ప్లేస్డ్ ఆన్ ఆల్వేస్ టాప్ పొజిషన్ టాప్ ఆఫ్ ద వర్టికల్ కాలమ్ టాప్ ఆఫ్ ద వర్టికల్ కాలమ్ యు హావ్ టు ప్లేస్ హైలీ ఆక్సిడైజబుల్ గ్రూప్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఫర్ హైలీ ఆక్సిడైజబుల్ గ్రూప్ కార్బాక్సిలిక్ యాసిడ్ ఆల్డిహైడ్ These are the highly oxidizable groups examples. Okay, so these are the highly oxidizable groups. So you have to place always top of the fissure, top of the vertical line in a fissure projection. This is the meaning of the fourth point. Okay, next few more examples you will see, and after that examples I will explain these three points. So are we clear, then? These are all the first four points. Okay. One of the most popular example again. I will start the special representation also with the lactic acid molecule. Lactic acid molecule for the CH3, CH, COOH, and OH. This is the lactic acid molecule. So now special representation. I will convert this molecule into special representation. Special representation is a cross-type model. Here this carbon four different groups are there. I will write like this. What is the intersection point in here? Here this is this carbon. This star carbon is this intersection point. So this carbon, four different groups are arranged. See now how I will arrange this. So what is the second point here? The longest carbon chain you are taking as a vertical line. So here 1, 2, 3. So this vertical line is this one. So next highly oxidizable group we should place the at the top of the position. Therefore I have to place COOH here. Now what about second carbon? This one second carbon and third carbon methyl group I will place here on vertical line. Next, so this line, this part is over. This part is already represented as a vertical line. Now what are the groups remaining here? Hydrogen and OH is remaining. Now I will place one OH here and another hydrogen. I will write OH this side or hydrogen this side. OH this side and this side. Right. So these, once you observe the relationship between these two molecules, the compound A is exactly minimized to the compound B. The compound A is exactly minimized to the compound B. Okay. So right. So next. So these four points. By basing on these four points, I will convert the normal lactic acid molecule to fissure projection. Next, come to fifth point here. 180 degree inclined rotation of fissure projection produces its identical compound. Before going to discuss about those three points, we should discuss about homomer, enantiomer. Enantiomer and diastereomer. Homomer, enantiomer and diastereomer we have to discuss. So for this one, first one, homomers I will discuss. Homomers means diisomers which are having same type of connectivity, and same type of arrangement in space. That means configuration is same, nothing but simply configuration is same. Diisomers which are having same configuration is nothing but homomer. Configuration means what? R and S. Always homomer. Suppose A, B, మనం ఇప్పుడు హోమోమర్స్ అనాలంటే ఏ యొక్క కాన్ఫిగరేషన్ ఆర్ అయితే బి యొక్క కాన్ఫిగరేషన్ కూడా ఆర్ అవ్వాలి. ఈ రెండు ఐసోమర్స్ అయ్యి ఏ యొక్క కాన్ఫిగరేషన్ ఆర్ అయితే బి యొక్క కాన్ఫిగరేషన్ కూడా ఆర్ అయితే వీటి మధ్య రిలేషన్ ఏమంటారంటే హోమోమర్స్. వాట్ ఇస్ ద రిలేషన్ బిట్వీన్ దీస్ టూ? హోమోమర్. ఓకే, సరే. నెక్స్ట్ టూ కాంపౌండ్స్ ఐ విల్ టేక్ ఏ అండ్ బి. టూ కాంపౌండ్స్ ఐ విల్ టేక్ ఏ అండ్ బి. These two are isomers. Isomers means same molecular formula. Isomers means what? Same molecular formula. But the configuration is different. That means A compound have R configuration, then B compound has S configuration different. These type of
this example for enantiomerism. Enantiomer. Okay. So what is? How can we define enantiomer? Means the pair which have mirror images, the pair which have mirror images and non-superimposable each other. So that those are called as enantiomers. What is enantiomer means? Enantiomer means nothing but handedness. So if you see, my hands like this, this hand, this my left hand is exactly mirror image of the right hand. Yes or no? My right hand is exactly mirror image to left hand and vice versa. And if I place my right hand on this left hand, see, this is not superimposed on this one. Not superimposed or not? Superimposing means what is that? If I place my hands like this, then this thumb is exactly fallen like this. So equivalent fingers are fallen like this. This is called as superimposability. This is superimposable character. But these two are mirror images and I place like this. No, these two thumbs are comes from away. This is like this, this is away from this one, this is and like this. This is not fall on this one. This is not superimposed. So therefore, right hand and left hand are enantiomers. The best example for right hand and left hand is enantiomers. Okay. So what is enantiomers? Mirror images and non-superimposable. The pair which is mirror images. Mirror image relationship those compounds have and non-superimposable character. So those compounds are called as enantiomers. Okay, so I will give one example. Observe these molecules. Observe this A and B. Here, lactic acid is like this. So see, A and B. A molecule is exactly mirror image of B and B molecule is exactly mirror image of A. Yes or no? This is mirror image or not? Exactly this mirror image. Now, bring this molecule and place here. So, this OH will fall on hydrogen and this hydrogen will fall on OH. Therefore, this is a mirror image to each other and non-superimposable. Therefore, A and B are, what is the relationship? Enantiomers. And enantiomers always have different configuration. If one enantiomer having R, another enantiomer having S. If one enantiomer having S, other enantiomer having R. So, see, how to check the configuration? Here, according to CIP rules, already you know, Kahn and Pillow proposes some rules to get the absolute configuration R and S. Here, this carbon, according to this carbon, oxygen is present, carbon, hydrogen and carbon is present. So, carbon atomic number 6, they are 6. 1 and 8. We always give more priority to the highest atomic number containing group. Here oxygen containing most highest atomic number. This is 1. Next, here carbon 6, here carbon 6. But after carbon, here hydrogen connection is there. But here oxygen connection is there. Therefore, the priority goes to carboxylic acid. Next, least. This is 3 and the least one is 4. Now, 1, 2, 3 anti-clockwise, but the least priority group is present on horizontal line. Therefore R becomes S, S becomes R. Here the configuration is S, therefore it converted to R. Why? Because the least priority group on always should be on vertical line, but it is present on horizontal line. The configuration R becomes S, S becomes R. Okay, so right, this is R. Now what is the configuration of this one? What is the configuration? Now check it. Highest atomic number 1, 2, 3 clockwise direction we will think R, but the least priority group for the this is on horizontal line, therefore R becomes S. One enantiomer R, one enantiomer S. Therefore at the chiral center the configuration of carbon is here R and here S. Therefore these two are enantiomers, mirror images and non-superimposable each other. These are examples for the enantiomers. Next, diastereomers. Next, diastereomers relationship means A and B are isomers. Non-mirror image relationship, and non-superimposable character. Non-mirror image character and non-superimposable character. Therefore, A and B are called as diastereomers. Diastereomers. One example, on hand and leg. There is any mirror image relationship between these two, hand and leg? No. This is superimposed. If I my hand is superimposed on my leg, no, it is not superimposed. Therefore, non-mirror images, non-superimposed world. Example, hand and leg. See? For diastereomers, we will see the example. Diastereomers, we will see the example. Cisbutane and transbutane. Cisbutane and transbutane. So, any mirror image relationship is there? Non-mirror image. If you place this trans compound on this cis compound, any superimposable character? No. No superimposable character? No. Mirror image relationship and no superimposable character. Therefore, these two are examples. Cis and trans compounds are examples for the diastereomers. Cis and trans compounds are examples for the diastereomers. Next, one more example I will take.
Different. One carbon having R, another pair having yes. RR, one enantiomer having RR configuration, another enantiomer having SS, like that exact opposite. But for an IRC universe, see, what you see here, after here, first there is no mirror image relationship and a non-superimposable. These are diastereomers. Once you observe the configuration at the C1, R existed, and at the C2, what is here? S existed. For its isomer, S existing, and here S only. If these two are enantiomers, then what is the relation? Should be RS becomes SR. But once you observe this one, RS, SS. Here, the chiral center configuration is same. That means, so finally, what is the conclusion for this example? So, in diastereomer molecules, one of the chiral center configuration is same. Another chiral center configuration is same. If this is, if these two are enantiomers, so the two chiral centers configuration should be opposite. One chiral center configuration R means in another enantiomer, that should be yes. Okay, so not be same. Not be same. This is called as a diastereomer. Next one, homomer. Last one is homomer. Homomer means, already I told you, same molecules. Homomer means same molecule. The isomers which are having mirror image relation, sorry, the isomers which are superimposable each other, therefore those type of molecules are called as homomers. Examples I will tell you. Meso compound. This compound only I will take, meso compounds. This mirror image I will take. This mirror image I will take. But what we will think exactly, this compound is exactly mirror image to each other. And if you place this molecule on this one, it is not superimposable. Therefore, blindly we will think that this is the relationship between these two enantiomers. But these two are homomers. How can we check homomer relationship means between any two compounds are given, if A and B? If B is different from A or not, how can we check? Rotate this molecule in 180 degree in plane. If you rotate this molecule in 180 degree in plane, therefore what we will get? In plane, in plane means if you molecule through, on the blackboard only you have to rotate, not out of plane. If you just place the molecule like this, you have to rotate. And now what will happen? OH, and this COOH come to this side, and upward carboxylic acid come to downward. Yes or no? Hydrogen, OH, OH. So, by rotating 180 degree, so we will get the third one. Now, observe the relationship between the first one and the third one. So, these two are exactly same. Yes or no? Same or not? If you place this molecule on this one, this is superimposable. So, by basing or by doing 180 degree rotation, you have to observe the given pair of compounds are homomers or enantiomers. Homomers or enantiomers. I will write the configuration. I will write the configuration here. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Actually, S, but this priority group. Therefore, here, without doing, I will write. Why? Because exactly the above half is mirror images to the below. Therefore, this is R, this is S. For this one, 1, 2, and 3. This is 3. 1, 2, 3. This is clockwise. This hydrogen. Okay. 1, 2, 3. This is clockwise rotation. But the least priority group, where it is present? Yes. But this one, exactly mirror image is to this one. This becomes R. But once you check this one, same or not? Therefore, R and S. Therefore, these two are homomers. These two are homomers. So, this is about the homomer, enantiomer, and diastereomers. So, now, briefly, once again, we will discuss what is enantiomer. Enantiomer means the isomers. First, the given compounds are isomers are not, you will check. Isomers means what? Having same molecular formula. Okay, right? Same molecular formula, but connectivity is different.
the connectivity of the atoms or groups in space is different. Okay, that one we check. First we will check the isomers or not. If it is the isomers, then you will check the mirror-image relationship. If mirror-image relationship is existing and superimposable character is not existing, if that is enantiomers. Enantiomers have always different configuration. Or chiral center configuration is R, another chiral center configuration should be yes. Enantiomers always should have different configuration, different absolute configuration. Next, enantiomer is over. Diastereomers. What is diastereomers means? The isomers which are not exhibiting any mirror image relationship or non-superimposable character. That you have to keep in mind. So what is that? Non-mirror images and non-superimposable character. Therefore, one of the chiral center, it should be same. Next, homomers means they are exhibiting superimposable character. The isomers which are having superimposable character, that means one pair you are taking, two molecules will fall exactly on the another molecule. Those compounds are called as homomers. Already we saw the just example, that is meso compounds. Two meso compounds of tartaric acid are considered as the homomers. Okay, so right. So this is about the enantiomer, isomers and homomers. Now let us discuss the last three points. 180 degree in-plane rotation of Fischer produces the identical compound. 180 degree in-plane rotation of Fischer produces the identical compound. Here we are doing 180 degree rotation or not? One pair is given to you. So we will check the relationship between these two. I will rotate this molecule in 180 degree. Therefore, I will get the same molecule. Therefore, that is homomers. Identical means homomers. Homo means same. Next, 90 degree in-plane rotation produces its enantiomer. We will discuss this one. What is the point? 90 degree in plane rotation. 90 degree in plane rotation produces its enantiomer. See, this is the straight line. What is the bond angle between this and this here? 180 degree. But here, 90 degree in plane rotation we have to do. That means the molecule just tilted to this OH come to here. This OH come to this side. This OH goes to this side. Okay? Understand? 90 degree in plane rotation. This COOH comes this side. COOH. Next, this OH will come like this. Here, what is present? Methyl group is present. This methyl group comes this fourth position and here hydrogen. Now I want to check the relationship between these two. That means relationship means either the two compound after performing 90 degree rotation, so the resultant molecule and the initial molecule. So what is the relationship between enantiomer or diastereomer or homomer? I am checking. How can I check homomer like this? First mirror image I will check. Here any mirror image is there? But not like this. Next, configuration you will check. Configuration. If it is enantiomer means R means becomes S, S becomes R. If diastereomers means what is that? R, or otherwise non-mirror images and a non-superimposable character. Now I will check. Here 1, 2 and 3. 1, 2, 3. This is like this. Anti-clockwise direction. What is the configuration here? Yes. Why? The least priority group is present on vertical side only, on vertical column only, on vertical line only. Therefore, there is no changing of configuration. Okay? So, it should be present on vertical line only. So, now it is anti-clockwise direction. Yes. Initial one has R and the final one after performing 90 degree rotation it having? Yes. Therefore, R and S, it is a mirror image relationship, non-superimposable. Therefore, these two relationship is enantiomers. The relationship between these two enantiomers like this. Okay, this is the meaning of the point. Next, one more example I will take. Active compound. Previously we did 90 degree rotation. Now I am doing 180 degree in-plane rotation. In-plane rotation means on the board or on the paper only you are rotating the molecule like that. Okay, so 180 degree rotation means what is that? This COOH comes this place and this CH3 goes to this side, and the OH comes to this side and this hydrogen comes to so right hand side. Okay, understand 180 degree rotation. Now see, exchanging of group COOH and the CH3, this OH will come here and this hydrogen. Now I want to observe the difference between these two molecules. So by assigning the configuration 1, 2 and 3, 1, 2, 3 in anti-clockwise, it becomes S, but the least priority group is present on hydrogen, therefore this is R. Here R, the resultant after performing 180 degree rotation, R, there is a mirror image relationship and it is superimposed on this one. Therefore R configuration, these two are co-homers. That only I want here. 180 degree in-plane rotation produces identical compounds or not? Identical compounds always have same configuration. If R, these two are identical means this having R means this chiral center also configuration R. This one having S, this one also having S. That is the main identification for the co-homers. Okay? Right. These two are the examples for the these two points. Next one. Any three group exchange at a SPNC center produces its enantiomer. See, any three group exchange. I will rewrite the lactic acid molecule, the COOH and the CH3OH, and then what is the point here? Last point, any three group exchange at a asymmetric center, this is the asymmetric center, this produces its enantiomer. So I will see any three group exchange. I will keep this CH3 as a static one. That means I won't touch this methyl group. I will place standard like this. So I will exchange these three groups. At a chiral center. CH3. Now I will run it. I will bring this COOH molecule here and this OH molecule. So okay, right like this. COOH. And this OH will goes to hydrogen position and the hydrogen will go occupies carboxylic acid position. Now as in the configuration, how can we know the relation between the two molecules means by basing on configuration. First, what is the configuration here? 1, 2, 3 anti-clockwise, but least priority group on horizontal line, therefore this is R. Here 1, next 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 clockwise direction. Least priority group are vertical only. Therefore, there is no change in configuration. Clockwise means R. Here R, same configuration. Therefore, these two are homomers. Therefore, what is the conclusion here? In Fischer projection at one chiral center, exchange of three groups produces its homomer or identical compound. This is the meaning. Okay? Right. You can check for any molecule like this. You can check for any two chiral center containing molecule, three chiral center containing molecule, any chiral center molecule. If you exchange three groups, it produces the same molecule or same center. How can you know same center? By assigning the configuration. R comes R. But the two group exchange, what will get? Enantiomer. Okay, important, these two points. Two group exchange will give enantiomer. Three group exchange will give its homomer, identical configuration. This is briefly about Fischer representation.
Right. Then say question guns.